Oh, yes, it's fun time. Fun time for me, fun time for you, fun time for everybody. Over in England, they crown her the queen of comedy. Paris calls her the funny lady in the land. So let's give a big warm welcome to my mom, your mom, everybody's mom. Let's meet and greet Jackie Moms Mabley. Come on, let me hear it.
I got something to tell you. Honey, I got in town the other day, and I was rushing to get me a room, you know. And the hotels looked like it was full. I went to the best place I could, and I had no one got in the room, and I started itching. I called up the desk clerk, and I said, he said, "What's eating you?" I said, "That's what I want to know." How you like mom's dress? You know you can get some real nice things with them green stamps, you know that? But mom, always such a nice theater. I'm so glad to be here at the State Theater. It's a beautiful place. Somebody done knocked a hole in the back of it already. No, it ain't. That's a snaggletooth woman. Woman, shut your mouth. But I was so glad to be here last Sunday to see the children and they used to say, you know, there's some good-looking women in Philadelphia. You know that? Yes, it is. I was at a fashion show down in Baltimore last week, and the women were so ugly until a man won. One spring day, I love the spring of the year, but that old man I married didn't mean a thing. I was there, I was young, 14 years old, and he was 89. Wasn't nothing on his mind, because his mind had stopped working. When he died all over. That man was really so weak until I don't understand him living. And ain't no need to say I didn't try to poison him, I did. Rat poison agreed with him, look like. One spring day last spring, I never will forget the last time he was living. Oh my goodness, the girls and the boys were strolling down Lover's Lane. The birds was birding. The squirrels were squirreling. The ducks were ducking. And he was dead. I said, "Do you know anything about the birds and the bees?" He said, "Yeah. A bird's a bird and a bee's a bee." Oh, it wasn't no need talking. That man was impossible. One evening we was sitting down at home. He's sitting over in the corner. You know, he's so weak. He said, "Will you please cross my leg for me?" I went over and slammed his leg down so hard, I tried to break it. And he looked at me real pitiful and said, "You're mean to me. Why must you be mean to me? honey, can't you see that I am really trying? I said, I don't know why. 'Cause first he said he would, and then he wouldn't. And then he thought he could, but really he couldn't. I said, Pop, you're finished now. So what are you trying to do? He said, I'm gonna try. I'll try forever. I said, oh, please, why don't you try to get yourself together? Look at you. You're shaking and nervous now. So forget what you think you can do. I said, why, you are old and bent, and you down to your last cent, and that don't make no sense, and you know it. On your head, you ain't got no hair, and you look like Jack the Bear. You are wrecked beyond compare, and damn if you don't show it. I say, make up your mind. Why not be fair? Give yourself a break and get the hell out of here. 'Cause I'm disgusted now, and no telling what I'm about to do. Oh, that old man made me so mad. Really, I was so disgusted, as I said, honey, forget it. Oh, thank you, all you darlings. You are dolls. Son, bring Mama a chair, will you please? I'm tired of standing up here. Everybody else is sitting down. I don't know why I can't. Bring me a chair, son. And everybody is looking at this book and wondering what it is. This is a book I want you to buy for your children. I've been telling you all about telling lies to your children. And now, is it the best chair you got, darling? My goodness, this chair's something, ain't it? Ow, it's cold, too. I don't want to catch no more cold. I got enough. I've been down with the flu, you know. I have. You know that dead was 80? I think I pulled him off too soon, you know. I heard up and put him back on, little baby. I ain't gonna pull them off no more than June the 20th. I'm gonna be sure it's warm. I'm telling you, this chair is nothing. This book concerns the situation. Oh, I forgot to tell you. Teacher the other day in school asked three boys, I want you to write an essay on what you would do if you had $1 million and bring it in when you come in tomorrow. Let that be your homework. So next day, the three little boys come in, you know, two boys and one little colored boy, you know. Yeah, it was indicated school, you know, it's indicated school. So they said to one of the little boys, said, Percy, oh, you've got a nice essay here. Y'all know what you'd do with $1 million. Oh, this is beautiful. You said you'd give your mother a new home and your father a new car and send your sister to college. I think that's wonderful. And said, then two, I'm very proud of you, David. Say, you know, you wrote a nice essay on what you'd do with $1 million. You know, that you'd buy your mother a Cadillac, and that you'd buy a mink coat, buy your father some teeth, and I think that's very nice. She looked on the paper and said, Johnny, your essay, your paper ain't got nothing on it. He said, yeah, that's just what I'd do if I had $1 million. Nothing. Little boy run home the other day from school. He run all the way just crying like his heart would break. He run in the house. His daddy said, what's the matter with you, boy? He said, a boy called me a sissy. He said, what'd you do? Say, I hit him with my pocketbook. I don't see why, children, that you all don't let Mom be president anyhow.
Well, you all vote for Mom to be president.
You know the friend? Would you all like that? Yeah. Wonderful. I'll tell John when I call him up again to get over. You know the first thing if I'd do if I was president? I'd give one a certain southern governor a job as ambassador to the Congo. And let him go crazy looking for a men's restroom with white on it. But they ain't so bad down there, they're getting better. Sheriff locked up a colored boy the other day. He said, I'm going to give you a break, you know it? And I'm going to do something for you. I'm going to get you a good lawyer and see that you get a fair trial. And then I'm going to hang you. You know one thing? I don't know what they're going to do down home next. I don't. I just really don't understand it. They just keep that poor man in trouble. One of us went down there, you know. One of us show people went down there. Talk about he gonna lead them. They led him. I got something to tell you. Honey, talk about somebody being scared. Picked up the paper yesterday morning and seen where Jackie was gonna have another baby. Like, they scared me to death. I thought they talking about me. Because I've been taking them pills, you know? Getting back to my book. I have wrote a book for my teenage children. Y'all call them delinquents and everything else, but I love them. They buy Mom's record, they love Mom, they dig Mom, and Mom digs them. You don't dig them because you're way back and hit a time and you ain't gonna change. And that's what's the matter with the country now, especially America. You got to change with the time. It's an atomic age, you got to have an atomic mind. Things ain't like they used to be, like a lot of old men say, well, times ain't like they used to be. I say, I'm damn glad of it. Who wants times like they used to be? They've been teaching the children and giving the children a bunch of lies and Mother Goose rhymes and different things for years. Mom wrote her Mother Goose book, and I want you to buy it. And if you don't want your children to know the truth about life, don't send them to the theater to see mom, because I'm going to tell them the truth, yeah? You teach them that Mother Hubbard went to the cupboard to get a dog a bone. I saved Mother Hubbard had her gin in the cupboard. You tell them Jack and Jill went up the hill after some water. I tell them the water don't run uphill. You tell them that Mary had a little lamb. I tell them wasn't the doctor surprised. Sure, the cow jumped over the moon. That's the only truth in there. Cow did jump over the moon. You'd have jumped too. That man's hand was cold. You tell him that the wolf ate up Red Riding Hood's grandmother. I tell him that if he did, they must have used tenderizer on him. As tough as grandmother was, that wolf had a hard time. My brother's dead on account of one of them paralyzed. My grandmother and them up in North Carolina. Daddy boy 15 years old. They still telling him ding dong bell, which is in the well. He got drowned like a fool when he jumped in. Up on him yet. I'll write about him later. I wrote buy mom's book and tell the children the truth. But mom has been away. A lot of people think I work for the government. But I don't. They only send for me when they want some advice about something they get stuck on in the world. Sometime I'm at the United Nations, and sometime I'm at the White House. And sometime I'm... But I don't have much time for that. I just completed a mission to the Congo. They had some trouble over there with somebody named Shambé. I thought that was the name of a dance until he started all that mess over there. Immediately, I called up my son, you know, Jack. And in return, he gave me John's telephone number because I misplaced it. So I called up John, down to the White House. I said, listen, son, lend me your plane. I want to, go to the Congo, and I want you to send your plane up here because they've been dropping. I want nothing to drop with me. So you better send me your plane and send me a bed to sleep in. Tell Big Maybell she's cooking at the White House now, you know. I said, tell Big Maybell to fix me a lunch because I can't eat that stuff like they eat over there. I'm not used to it. Crocodile dumplings, you know. Lizard casseroles and things like that. I said, you better call up the United Nations and tell Adelaide that I said to let Ralph go with me. Cause he's one of the bunch, you know? So me and him left for the Congo. And the best way that I can describe what happened is in two parts. As there was trouble in two parts of the world at the same time, I have to fix my opera in two parts. Part once is the Congo. Would you mind changing the light on me, please, darling? Make me look as sexy as possible, please. How come you sit down there? You've been sitting down there for three shows. Look at that little boy sitting down there. Ain't he cute? Son, you must have heard about Mom, have you? Keep sitting there grinning at me. Oh, I don't care what you are. I know what you are. But you see, we can go with you all up here. Yeah, I dig you later, son. Cause I dig you. Luther, my new boyfriend Luther, that's the piano player. Yeah, me and Brooks is broke up. Me and Brooks met my boyfriend, we broke up. He had a birthday the other day, he was 29. Too old for me, honey. Anytime you see me with a man over 22, he's one of my relatives, you know? So now it's Luther at the piano. That's him. Don't he look nice? Ain't I got him looking good? Man, that's a silk suit he's got on. He ain't even had a silk shirt before, much less a silk suit. He's cute as he wants to be. And baby, he can play that piano. Baby, he plays a piano, honey. And I got a big old beat up piano at home. He kills me, baby. When he starts playing up there in them little keys. Oh, my toes get real stiff. I don't know what to do. The opera. We went over to the Congo. I met Chambé, and I said to him, we were sent here to the Congo just to try to talk to you. You got everybody worried, what the hell you trying to do? Now we got to get back home because we have trouble there too. So let's get through with you. And Chambé said to me, Binga Banga Bonga, what's the matter with the Congo? I said, that's what I want to know. You got brother fighting brother and they're killing one another and that stuff's got to go. I said, come here a minute, Chambé. I want to whisper something in your ear. I said, I know a certain hiding place where you can hide that ugly face. Do you want me to reserve a space? It's called the Mumbles Hideaway. You want to go today? He says, oh no. No, no. I said, then
straighten up and fly right, 'cause you know you ain't prepared to fight. Now if you wanna do right, cool down, Papa, or we'll blow your top. I said another thing. Someday, someday, yes, you're gonna be sorry. But what you do and what you say, pick the piano, Luca, pick the piano. You're a smart guy, and I can't see why that you'd let Khrushchev sell you a lie. Why he booed Castro and poor Nauru, and he'll do the same to you someday, someday. What would I say? Then we went back to America, and no sooner we got back to America, there was trouble happening in another part of the world they call Mississippi. A young man was grieving his heart out because he couldn't understand. I said, what's the matter, son? He said, Mom, I don't want to give up law and they're dissatisfied. But just to save my hide, I think I'd be better off outside. I should have quit school the night they shot it, sis. Mom, you don't know what kind of place it is. I can't study law no more. Cause way down here in the land of cotton, civil rights are still forgotten. Stay away from Dixieland. Now, Mom, you may think that I'm just joking, but I'd like to catch the first thing smoking to get away. From Dixieland. You see, I wish I could leave Dixie. I'd say, hooray. Though I was born, I don't see why I have to die in Dixie. Call me. I want a degree. But it's tough to get in Dixie. I said, son, tell them. Tell all of them. Then Mom said that there's no difference under the skin. I don't know why they won't let you stay in. He said, Mom, all that is true, but every time I do, they make me stop before I begin. I say, well, my advice then is somewhere over where there's no Jim Crow, you must fly. Because if the Supreme Court can't fix it so you can stay there, how can I? I'm sorry.
I'm going to go to the hospital.